Let me close with a really moving poem entitled Father Forgets. And this is a dad who is feeling the regret of not parenting his child in a way that love and logic promotes. And I hope you dads, especially listening, will pick up on this. It says, "Listen, son, I'm saying this as you lie asleep, one little hand crumpled under your cheek and blonde curls sticky over your wet forehead. I have broken into your room alone just a few minutes ago as I sat reading my paper in the library. A stifling wave of remorse swept over me. Guilty, I came to your bedside. There are things which I am thinking, son. I had been cross to you. I scolded you as you were dressing for school because you gave your face a mere dab with the towel. I took you to task for not cleaning your shoes. I called you out angrily when you threw some of your things on the floor. At breakfast, I found you at fault too. You spilled things. You gulped down your food. You put your elbows on the table. You spread butter too thick on your bread. As you started off to play, I made for my train and you turned and waved a hand and called, 'Goodbye, Daddy.' And I frowned and said in reply, 'Hold your shoulders back.' Then it began all over again late this afternoon as I came up the road. I spied you down on your knees playing marbles. There were holes in your socks. I humiliated you before your friends by marching you ahead of me to the house. Socks were expensive, and if you had to buy them, you would be more careful. Imagine that, son, from a father. Do you remember later when I was reading in the library how you came timidly with your sort of hurt look in your eyes? I glanced up over my paper, impatient at the interruption. You hesitated at the door. 'What is it that you want?' I snapped. You said nothing but ran across in one tempestuous plunge, threw your arms around my neck and kissed me. Your small arms tightened with affection that God had set blooming in your heart, which even neglect could not wither. Then you were gone, pattering up the stairs. Well, son, it was shortly after that my paper slipped from my hands and a terrible, sickening fear came over me. What has habit been doing to me? The habit of finding fault or reprimanding. This was my reward to you for being a boy. It was not that I did not love you. It was that I expected too much of you. I was measuring you by the yardstick of my own years. There is so much that was good, fine and true in your character. The little heart of yours was as big as the dawn itself over the hills. This was shown by your spontaneous impulse to rush in and kiss me goodnight. Nothing else mattered. Tonight, son, I've come to your bedside in the darkness. I've knelt here, ashamed. It is a feeble atonement. I know that you would not understand these things which I have told you in the waking hours. Tomorrow, I'm going to be a real daddy. I will chum with you, suffer when you suffer, laugh when you laugh. I will bite my tongue when impatient words come. I will keep saying as if it were my ritual, 'He's nothing but a boy, a little boy.' I'm afraid I visualized you as a man. Yet as I see you now, son, crumpled up and weary in your bed, I see that you are still a baby. Yesterday, you were in your mother's arms, your head on her shoulder. I have asked too much, too much." Dude.
Wow. This is kind of messed up because I can't go to the store and buy Kleenex right now. And the last time I went, they were out. And then you do this. That's powerful.
We are too harsh.
Can I say one final quick word of encouragement to all the Brooks Gibbs fans? You're watching something like this. You're interested in Brooks' material. You're interested in Love and Logic. To me, that says that you want to do this right. You want to do this well, and you know, good for you, and God bless you. The people who are seeking to do this better, this raising kids stuff, those people are like gold, because there are too many people who aren't putting that much thought into it, and they're not even slowing down enough to regret the times that they've hurt their kids' feelings or neglected them. So if you're one of those people who's trying to get better at being a mom or dad or teacher or mentor, bless you. and we appreciate you. Thanks, and you can do this.
You can do this if you will. And that's the message of this poem. Tomorrow, I'm gonna be different. And you know what? That's the commitment we should make. Because in the moment of clarity, we have that guilt. And we need to be responsive to that. Because time is ticking, these kids are growing, and we need to not harm them. We need to help them. And that is critical, that we reflect a loving heart, just like my Heavenly Father loves me unconditionally.